Good morning, student. Due to some technical problem, last lecture was not audible to you. So I am repeating that lecture. When two even signals are multiplied, we get an even signal. Here, t square is even signal and t raised to power 6 is even signal. And we get t raised to power 8 is also even signal. So when two even signals are multiplied, we get an even signal. T raised to power 2 multiplied by t raised to power 3, this is even signal and this is odd signal. We get t raised to the power 5. Which is odd signal. When we multiply two odd signals, we get an even signal. When t raised to power 3, which is odd signal, is multiplied by t raised to the power 5, which is also odd signal, we get an signal. T raised to the power 8, which is an even signal. So when two odd signals are multiplied, we get an even signal. X of t is equal to t raised to power 4 plus cos t. Here, t raised to the power 4 is even signal. Cos t is also even signal. And if we place minus t in place of t, we get t raised to the power 4 plus cos t, which is equal to x of t. Here, x of t is equal to x of minus t. It means that this signal is even signal. And we can also say that when two even signals are added, we get an even signal. In this question, x of t is equal to x square, t square plus sin t. T square is even signal, sin t is odd signal. If we add minus, if we place minus t in place of t, we get this equation, and in this case x of t is not equal to minus x of t. It means that this signal is not odd signal, and x of t is also not equal to x of minus t, means this signal is not an even signal. So when even signal is added with odd signal, we get a signal which is neither even signal nor odd signal. Here, x of t is equal to sin t plus sin t plus t raised to the power 5. If we place minus t in place of t, we get this equation. And in this equation, x of t is equal to minus x of t. Sorry, x of minus t is equal to minus x of t. So, this is an odd signal. When two odd signals are added, we get an odd signal. Any arbitrary continuous or discrete time signal can be expressed as a summation of even part and odd part. Means here, x of t is an any arbitrary continuous time signal. Any continuous or any discrete time signal can be represented by even part plus odd part. Xe of t is even part of signal and x naught of t is odd part of signal. And xe of t is given by half x of t plus x of minus t, where x naught of t is given by half x of t minus x of minus t. So this is the signal. And the signal, value of signal is constant. Or we can say that this is a DC signal. So if we take the mirror image of this signal about the y-axis, then we get x of minus t and x of t, x of value of x of minus t is equal to 2. So we can say that x of t is equal to x of minus t is equal to 2. So DC signal or a constant value is almost a even signal. X of t is equal to cos square pi by 2 t. Here we apply a formula cos square theta is equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta divided by 2. So we get this formula and we get half plus half cos pi t. Half is constant. Half is constant, it means that this is even signal. Cos pi t is also constant. So when we add two even signal, we get an even signal. It means that this signal is even signal. Similarly, in next question, x of t is given by sine t square. If we place minus t in place of t, we get sine t square, and in this case, x of t is equal to x of minus t, so this is an even signal. Find even part and odd part of the signal. Here signal is given and you have to find out even part and odd part of this signal. Constant part is always even signal. T square is even signal. Sine t is odd. Cos t is even signal. T is odd. Sine square t is even. T raised to the power 4 is even. And t raised to the power 3 is odd signal, and sine square sine t, size of sine t is also an odd signal. So even part is this even part. Even part divided by odd part is odd part. Even part divided by odd part is odd part. But even part divided by even is even part, and when two odd signals are multiplied, we get an even signal. So even part is given by this equation and odd part is given by this. Clear? And next question, draw the even and odd component of signal x of t. Even component is given by half x of t. In this signal, sorry, even part of signal is given by half of x t, half x t plus x of minus t. Draw the even part and odd component of signal x of t, and even component is given by half x of t plus x of minus t. So this is x of t. If we take the mirror image of this signal about y-axis, we get x of minus t. Then we add these two signals and divide by half. So we get the final signal. Similarly, for odd part is given by half x of t minus x of minus t. This is x of t. Take the mirror image of this along about y axis, you get x of minus t. And if you take the mirror image of this signal about x axis, you get minus x of t. Then add minus of x, minus x of t and x of t, and divide them by half. So you get odd part of signal. Periodic and non-periodic signal. Periodic signal, in continuous periodic signal, x of t plus capital T is equal to x of t, where capital T is real number. It means that x of t plus 2.5 is equal to x of t, then signal is periodic. And if x of t plus 5 is equal to x of t, signal is periodic. Means value of t is any real number in this case. But in case of discrete signal, x of n plus capital N is equal to n, but here small n is integer and capital N is also integer. Capital N is the number of samples in one cycle. And we know that number of samples in one cycle is always an integer number. Fundamental time period. It is the smallest positive and fixed value of time for which signal is periodic. Find the fundamental time period of signal x of t and x of n. Here x of t is given by sine 3 pi t, and we know that sine 3 pi t, 3 pi is omega, because we always write sine omega t. It means that value of omega is 3 pi, and value of omega is given by 2 pi by t. We calculate t is equal to 2 pi by omega. Value of omega is 3 pi. So fundamental time period of this signal is 2 by 3. In this case, x of n is equal to sine 3 pi by n. 3 pi n. Same signal, this is continuous signal and this is discrete signal. Calculated time period is 2 by 3, but this time period, 2 by 3, is not the time period of this signal, because here n should be integer. It means that if this discrete signal is converted into continuous signal, then 2 by 3 becomes the time period of that continuous signal. In previous lecture, I told you that you can get discrete signal by sampling continuous signal. So this 2 by 3 is the time period of that continuous signal from which this discrete signal is all these are the time period of the given signal 2 by 3, 4 by 3, 3 by 3 and 8 by 3 and 10 by 3. Minimum integer value is 2. So time period of this discrete signal will be 2. Clear hai? Means ye signal jo hai, ye continuous signal aur ye hai discrete signal. This is continuous hai. If we sample this continuous signal, we get a discrete signal. ये जो calculated value है, ये calculated value जो है, ये है time period of this signal. क्योंकि यहाँ पे जो है, तो मैं क्या होना चाहिए, n की value integer में आनी चाहिए. And these are the values of time period 2 by 3, 4 by 3, and this is the minimum integer value. So time period of this signal is 2. In continuous periodic signal, if we add two periodic signals, we get either a periodic signal or a periodic signal. But if periodic signal is added with अपीरियोडिक सिग्नल वी ऑलवेज गेट अपीरियोडिक सिग्नल एंड अपीरियोडिक सिग्नल इज एडेड विद अपीरियोडिक सिग्नल टू गेट ऑनली अपीरियोडिक सिग्नल बट इन डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिग्नल इफ टू पीरियोडिक सिग्नल्स आर एडेड वी ऑलवेज गेट अ पीरियोडिक सिग्नल periodic signal is added with aperiodic signal we get aperiodic signal similarly aperiodic signal is added with aperiodic signal we get aperiodic signal next question is determine whether or not each of the following signal is periodic if signal is periodic specify its time period periodic signal ke liye kya karna hoga if x1 T and if x1 t plus capital T both are equal, then this signal is periodic. X1 t is equal to j sine j exponential j 10 t, and we know that we can write exponential signal by j omega t. And this 10 is a value of omega is given by 10, and we substitute or place t plus capital T in place of t, we get this equation. And if exponential j 10 t is equal to 1, in that case this signal is periodic. Here omega is 10, value of omega is given by 2 pi by t. If we calculate the value of t, it is given by pi by 5. So this signal is periodic and time period is given by pi by 5. In discrete signal, we have to prove that this signal is periodic. Place n plus capital N in place of n, and we get this equation. If in this equation, if exponential 7 pi n is 1, then this signal is periodic, and if 7 pi by n should be multiple of 2 pi, then this is 1, and from this we calculate the value of n is 2 pi m by 7 pi, and if value of n is 7, then time period is क्वेश्चन में भी इसी प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन की तरह इसको भी सॉल्व करो प्लेस एन प्लस कैपिटल एन इन प्लेस ऑफ एन एंड यू गेट दिस इक्वेशन इफ वैल्यू ऑफ एक्सपोनेंशियल जे 3 पाई बाय एन इज 1 देन दिस सिग्नल इज पीरियडिक इट मींस दैट इफ 3 बाय 5 एन इज इक्वल टू 2 पाई एम In this case, n is equal to 2 pi m multiplied by 5 by 3. But due to presence of this pi, n can never be integer. So this signal is non-periodic. Time period of signal is unaffected by time shifting or time reversal, amplitude reversal, amplitude shifting and changing phase of signal. Sum of two or more than two periodic signals will be periodic if ratio of their fundamental time period or frequency are rational numbers. Find the fundamental time period of signal if it is periodic. इसका अर्थ है अगर ये periodic है तो इसका जो है fundamental time period हमें कैलकुलेट करना है और ये क्या है सम ऑफ टू पीरियोडिक सिग्नल एक्स ऑफ टी इज सम ऑफ टू पीरियोडिक सिग्नल ओमेगा इज 2 एंड इन दिस केस ओमेगा इज 4 पाई देन ओमेगा 1 डिवाइडेड बाय ओमेगा 2 इज 2 बाय 4 पाई व्हिच इज इरेशनल नंबर इट मींस दैट एक्स ऑफ टी इज नॉन पीरियोडिक सिग्नल x of t is given by sine 2 pi t plus cos under root 2 pi t. Omega is given by 2 pi. Omega 2 is given by under root 2 pi. And ratio of omega n, ratio of omega 1 and omega 2 is under root 2, which is irrational number, hence the signal is non-periodic signal. Next is f sn is given by s1n plus s2n, where these are discrete time periodic signals with period. This period of this signal is 90 and period of this signal is 54. Then find out that this signal is periodic, and if this signal is periodic, calculate the fundamental time period. N1 divided by N2 is 90 by 54, which is 3 by 5 by 3, rational number. So this signal is periodic, and if you take the LCM of 90 and 54, you get the fundamental time period of SN. Determine the fundamental period of discrete time signal. X of n is given by this expression, and if n1 2 pi by 3 is equal to 2 pi k, then you calculate the value of n1. Similarly, in this case, n2 multiplied by 3 pi 4 is equal to 2 pi k, then n2 is equal to 8 by 3. N1 divided by N2 is 9 by 8, which is the number. Hence, x of n is periodic signal, and LCM of fractional number is given by LCM of numerator divided by LCM of denominator. LCM of numerator means LCM of 3 and 8 is 24, and HCF of 1 and 3 is 1. So total time period or fundamental time period of this signal is 24. Power and energy signal. Power signal is given by formula 1 by t, integration minus t by 2 to t by 2, square of mod of x of t dt. This is for periodic signal, and for non-periodic signal, it is given by limit t approaches infinity 1 by t, integration t by minus t by 2 to t by 2, square of mod of x of t dt. Calculate the power of signal. In this signal, this is the straight line. So an equation of a straight line is given by this formula. Here x1 and y1 is minus 1 minus 1, and x2 1 and y2 is 1. So if we substitute these values in this equation, we get x of t is equal to t. Formula for power signal is given by 1 by t, integration minus t by 2 to t by 2 x square t by into dt. X square t, substitute the value of x square t, which is given by t, and solve this integration, we get 1 by t. Every normalized power is non-zero and finite, and this signal is power signal. In this question, calculate the power and energy of signal. Power is given by this formula, and apply cos square theta is equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta divided by 2. We get this expression, and in this expression, put the value of this term is 0, because average value of cos theta is always 0. And when we solve this expression, we get power is equal to a square by 2, where a is the amplitude of this periodic signal. It means that power is given by square of amplitude divided by 2. Similarly, we can calculate total energy of this signal. Total energy of signal is given by this formula, and when we apply cos square theta is equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta divided by 2, we get this expression, and value of this is 0, because average value of cos theta is 0. And here, if we substitute these limits, we get energy is infinite. So power is finite, energy is infinite, and this signal is power signal. Determine the value of P infinite and E infinite, energy infinite and power infinite for each of the following signals. X1 T is equal to exponential minus 2T UT. UT is unit step function. Unit step function is 0 for T is less than 0. Here, this limit minus infinite changes to 0, and we get this expression integration 0 from infinity exponential minus 2t dt. And if we integrate this equation and substitute the limits, we get this expression exponential minus infinity is 0, exponential 0 is 1. So we get 1 by 4. Value of infinite energy is 1 by 4. It means that total energy is finite and non-zero. And if we calculate infinite power or power of this signal, then limit infinite power means power for this signal is limit P approaches infinite value of total energy divided by T. Power of this signal is given by limit T approaches infinite total energy divided by T, which is equal to 0, because value of T is infinite in this case. Second is X is given by this formula exponential J 2T plus pi by 4. Pi by 4 is the field angle of signal. Time period is given by 2 pi by omega. Value of omega is 2. So time period is pi. Total energy over one period is given by this energy of only one period. Is given by 0 to t square of mod of signal x of t multiplied by dt. And mod of this signal is always 1. So we get the value of one cycle is pi. And exponential j omega is periodic signal, so there are infinite number of period in this signal. If in one period value of energy is pi, then for infinite number of periods, value of energy is infinite. Then we calculate power of one period is given by power of energy of one period divided by T, and this is equal to 1. So average power is limit T approaches 0, 1 is equal to 1. Value of पावर इज वन, फाइनाइट एंड नॉन जीरो, वैल्यू ऑफ टोटल एनर्जी इज इनफाइनाइट, सो दिस सिग्नल इज पीरियोडिक. Question is, find the power and energy of cos t. Energy of one period is given by integration 0 to t square of mod of x of t dt. And if we substitute the value of cos square t, we get this expression. And solving this expression by integrating and substituting the limits in the equation, we get T by 2. This is the energy in one period. And cos T is periodic signal. There are infinite number of periods. So total energy is infinite. While power in one period is given by energy in one period divided by T, which is T by 2 divided by T is half. Means this signal is periodic because power is finite, total energy is infinite. And next question, signal is given by this equation U of n. It means that this is unit step in a signal. Unit step signal is 0 for n is less than 0, and it is given by this equation when n is greater than or equal to 0. Calculate the total energy. Limit n approaches 0, summation n is minus infinity to n, x of n square of mod of x of n. Substitute the value of x of n, we get this expression. And if we expand this series, we get a geometrical series. And if the summation of geometrical series is 4 by 2. So in this case, in this signal, energy is finite and non-zero. Then calculate total power. Total power is given by this equation. And if we substitute the value of x of n in this equation, we get total energy divided by 2n plus 1 is equal to 0. Power is 0, energy is finite, so this signal is power, and this signal is energy signal. Class is over, thank you. Thank you.